Do you want to create cinematic shots and insane angles with your 360 camera? In this video, I'm going to show you a free software and tutorial for doing just that. You'll learn how to reframe your videos and photos from almost any 360 camera from within the same app. I'll also show you the no-stitch workflow for Insta360 without Adobe Premiere. And I'll also show you the absolutely fastest way to edit your videos. It's an exclusive technique you're not gonna learn anywhere else. By the way, this video is gonna show you how to edit your videos as a freecapture, overcapture, or reframed non-360 video. If you wanna edit your 360 video to show it as 360 or in VR, then check out my other tutorial. The software that we're gonna be learning today is Insta360 Studio for One X, version 3. And it has the feature that most of you have been asking for, which is the ability to edit free capture videos. This software works with most 360 cameras, not just from Insta360, and can edit videos up to 5.7K and adds new features that we're gonna talk about in this Insta360 Studio for One X tutorial. And its coolest feature is the no-stitch workflow with stabilization. And this works with any Insta360 camera, not just the One X. So even if you don't have Premiere, you're gonna be able to edit your videos without stitching them first. Now, why is that important? I'll tell you in a bit. By the way, this channel is about 360 and 3PV cameras. If you wanna learn more about this exciting new way to shoot your videos, then go ahead, hit subscribe, and don't forget to hit the notification bell. During the Korean War in 1950, the world saw its first jet versus jet dogfights. The US had the F-86 Sabre, while the North Koreans were using the MiG-15. The MiG-15 surprised the Americans because it could climb faster and was more maneuverable than the F-86 Sabre. Here's the curious thing. In dogfights, the F-86 would win 9 times out of 10. Now, a well-known fighter pilot named John Boyd analyzed why this was happening. What he noticed was that the MiG-15 had a manual flight stick, while the F-86 had a hydraulic flight stick. Think of it kind of like manual steering on really old cars versus power steering. Even though the MiG-15 was more maneuverable than the F-86, it took more effort to execute the moves. And that's why the F-86 beat the MiG-15. So what does this have to do with 360 cameras? When choosing 360 cameras, a lot of people are very focused on image quality. Actually, a factor that I think is more important than that is workflow. Workflow? What's that? Well, workflow just means the process that you have to go through from shooting all the way to sharing your photos and videos. Now, when you use a camera that has a faster and easier workflow, that means you can edit your videos more quickly, which means that you get more practice. And that's how you get better, faster. Let's check out Insta360 Studio for One X. All right, so I've launched Insta360 Studio and I've loaded my photos here on the left side. First thing you see is this kind of like a warped view. It's called equirectangular view, and it's the standard view for 360 photos and videos. We've changed the view to a 360 view. We click on this rectangle in the upper right corner to change the projection, like the kind of view that we're gonna use. So if, let's say we click on fisheye. So now we should see a fisheye view and we can look around. Now, we're not editing the video at this point. We're just looking at it and we're just changing the way it's shown. Perspective would be a rectilinear view. So besides changing the view, you can also change the stabilization mode here. And you can see there are two stabilization modes. To learn the difference between them, let's check out this other video that I shot. So here we're at the famous Dumbo ride at Disneyland. And you can see, you know, that it just goes around and around. With the normal stabilization mode, you can see that the camera is always pointed the same direction. So let's say here, for example, you see that that mountain in the background, the Matterhorn Mountain, you see that no matter how the ride turns, the camera's always facing that mountain. But for other videos, the direction hold mode works better. Let's try it out. Let's click on lock direction. And now you see this time, the view is stabilized, but it's stabilized according to the view of the camera instead of the background. So for example, here, you know, if we look forward, then it's always going to stabilize and show you the forward view of the camera, not the background.
Here's a tip. Using direction lock in Tiny Planet mode can give your Tiny Planet a different spin.
You can also change the stitching mode depending on if you're using one of these other special cases like the venture case or the dive case. Just click on the radio button for that and you'll be able to get a smoother stitch for the case. From here, you can do two things. You can, number one, export the video. Just click on this export and it will be exported as a 360 videos here. Just click on OK. You can also get a snapshot. So for example, here, turn around here, and if I wanted to get a shot of me and my daughter, click on this camera icon and it's going to create this snapshot. So you can adjust it how you want. Say here like that and then take a snapshot of that. But the focus of this video is editing your 360 video and using it as a non-360 video. Why would we want to do that? Because you can get some cinematic shots with your 360 camera. So to begin editing in overcapture mode, just click on this free capture button on top. Notice that this video is still unstitched in INSV format, but you can begin editing it in free capture. This is the no stitch workflow for Insta360 cameras that doesn't need Adobe Premiere. It's really one of the best features of Insta360 cameras. There's several advantages to it. First of all, it's faster and easier. Just begin editing. You don't have to wait to stitch. Second, you'll save space because you don't have to like create a separate stitched file. So that's one less file to deal with. You're just using the unstitched file. And then you're gonna have the edited version, and that's it. And then the third advantage is the image quality, because every time you stitch the video, there's gonna be a little bit of compression going on. So by skipping the stitching process, you skip one level of compression. So we preserve the image quality as much as possible all the way through the edited video. Now let's begin editing with free capture mode. So with the free capture mode, one of the things that you can do is change the aspect ratio of the final video. So by default, it's 16:9, but if you click on this button, you can see other options like a square, 4/3, vertical, or even anamorphic. And if you want some other ratio, you can do that. Just click on custom. The only limits are that the horizontal resolution must be divisible by 16, and the vertical resolution must be divisible by 8. For example, 2544 by 1080, that would be close to anamorphic. A while ago, I said that the main reason for using a 360 video as a non-360 video is to get cool camera moves. And the way we do that is through keyframes. Now, what are keyframes? Well, keyframing is a concept that was originally from traditional animation. So you know how like they need thousands and thousands of drawings for traditional animation? They had these lead animators, like the master artists. And what the master artist would do is just draw like key positions. For example, like a hand here, and then a hand like this. And then there would be these other animators called in-betweeners, and they would draw the intermediate positions, like from here. They would move it and slowly close the hand, something like that. So video editing also uses the concept of keyframes to make gradual changes, such as, in this case, panning the camera. So let's say in this video, we want to pan the camera from this view to another view. So what we do is create a keyframe by clicking on this keyframe button here. And now that creates a keyframe over there. Now we could adjust the keyframe, you know, we could change the view however we want, let's say this view. And we can even change the kind of projection. So let's say from a fisheye view, we want like a tiny planet, or let's say rectilinear view. So let's start out with a fisheye view. Now let's play the movie and decide at which point we want to add a keyframe. So let's say we want a keyframe right here. So we pause it, create another keyframe, and again, decide, you know, what kind of view it will be. So let's say it will be now a forward view. And, you know, let's say we want it to be rectilinear. We can do that. So now we go back, and because we've already created the keyframe from the starting position and the ending position, the software can figure out all the intermediate steps. So watch this, I'm gonna click on play, and it's gonna transition slowly into the forward view. Besides adding keyframes, changing the view and the projection, all that, you can also move keyframes around. So just drag them around like this. So let's say I wanna move the keyframe like that, I can do that. Or you can delete it by right-clicking on it and clicking on delete. And if you want to add a keyframe in between, you can do that as well. So if I wanted to create a new keyframe here. Now, in addition to keyframes, you can also control transitions. If you click on this line here, it shows you the kind of transition it's using. Right now, it's a smooth dissolve, just a gradual, smooth transition. Now, you can also change it so that it's fast to slow, or slow to fast, or fast, slow, fast, slow. Here, for example, we'll do a fade in, fade out. So that means slow, fast, slow. So this, here's what it looks like. So it's going to start out slowly, and then it goes fast, and then decelerates. So it kind of makes it look more natural. Now, one of my favorite types of transitions, though, is none. This is actually just a cut. So here's how it looks. So from here, it just shows that view, and then boom, it just suddenly shows a cut. Sometimes it's more effective than panning everything, which can get a little tiring after a while. That's basically it for keyframes. So easy. After this, all you have to do is click on this export button. You'll be prompted to save the file, and that means that next time you open the video, all your keyframes will still be there. As you saw, it's pretty easy, but what if you're in a hurry and you just don't even want to do any keyframes? So don't worry, there's a shortcut. Let me show you. So here I am at our hotel lobby, and we're gonna learn the shortcut to making overcapture videos. So let's say I wanted a video where I was pointing to the chandelier there, and then to the painting over there, and then to myself, because let's say it's a vlog. One way to do it would be to keyframe it. I can just like hold the camera here. I'll just keyframe it to point to the chandelier, and then to the painting, and then to myself. But let's say I wanted to do it without keyframing. Here, we just turn on the camera. The side with the lens is the front, going to be the front of the camera. So once you start recording, just point the front to where you want to point. So let's say here, we're going to point to the chandelier like that. So it's the front is now pointed to the chandelier. Point the front to the painting, boom, like that. Just point to the painting and then point it to me, like this. Hey guys, I'm vlogging, that's it.
In Studio, I just load the file, go to Free Capture, turn on Lock Direction, and hit on Export, that's it, we're done.
It's now pointed to the chandelier, point the front to the painting, boom, like that. Point to the painting and then point it to me like
now
this.
When you're using the One X this way, are you defeating the purpose of using a 360 camera? Not at all. You still have super stabilization and the ability to use it as a third person view camera. It's also easier to aim the camera since all you have to do is be aware of which is front and which is back.
Don't have a 360 camera yet? Check out my epic review of the Insta360 One X. Or do you want to learn the basics of shooting with a 360 camera? Check out this video. Thanks, and I'll see you in 360.